we will like to show you the other option of Pearson MyLab, which is Pearson eText. So whenever the students are enrolling to a particular course of the faculty, the students will also get to see and access an entire virtual book. And to access that, what they can do is they can click on the particular course that they are enrolled to. So right now I'm using marketing management title. So once you click on the particular title, so you will get to see the home page, or else course home page. Here on left hand side there is an option Pearson eText, so you can click on this. Once you click on Pearson eText, so you will get a link to access this eText. You can just click on it and the eText will get loaded in the other page. And you can also see that this Pearson eText is also available through an application format, wherein the students can download a free app from their App Store or Google Play Store. Okay, so this is entirely free of cost, and the students can use the same user ID and password to access this eText on the go. Now, what are the features that we can see here in this eText? So when I'm talking about eText, so this provides the students the entire the comfort in reading a particular or a physical copy of the book. Okay, so this comes with multiple options here. As you can see here, there is a menu option. When you click on it, you can get to see the detailed table of contents or index page of the particular title, starting with the cover page, copyright, dedication, and so on. And then you can just scroll it down to check. This entire book is divided into various parts. So you can see the part name and the headings over here. And when you click on the required part, you can see the chapter names over there. Okay, so you can select the required chapter again, and then you can see that each and every chapter is having the topics and then the subtopics. Okay, so this is the easy navigation which we have created for the students, so that they can directly jump into the required subtopic and they can start reading the particular concept on their own. So once they select the required subtopic to start reading, so they can close this menu option here, and here is the book where they can see and start reading it. So I'm just scrolling it down, and I can also see some highlighted keywords here. So what are these? So these are certain new words, or else new terminology, or I can say it's a jargon of marketing language. Marketing, so that the students can click on these words to get the definition or the meaning of this particular word. Okay, so this helps the students in clearing their concepts and strengthening their understanding with respect to the subject. So once they read about the particular topic, they can just click on and then they can continue their reading. Okay, so while reading, so they if they thought of like highlighting some important information, so they can always do that by selecting a portion of the textbook here. So while reading, if they thought of highlighting some important point and adding their own comments to that important point, they can always do that. And the process is that simply they can select the portion of the information that they want to highlight. As and when they select the information, they'll get to see these three color palettes, so they can select any color. And then automatically, when you click on the required color, so you will get to see an edit, share, and delete options. So click on edit, and when you click on edit, it provides you an empty space wherein you can write your own comments or notes with respect to this particular topic. So right now, as I'm using the faculty's account, so faculty is also having a function, or it's another feature, wherein they can highlight the portion of information, they can add the notes, and then they can share these notes to the students, so that as and when the students log into their account and they refer this particular page, they can get to see this particular information on their page already highlighted and saved. So I'm clicking here on save. Once I am done with this, and for future references, whenever that I wanted to revise my topic, so I can use all these notes with the help of menu and notebook option. So when I click on notebook, I can see all the pages or all highlighters that I have added in my account, and I can select all of them and I can download them in a PDF format. Once the notes is ready for the downloading, yeah, I'll get the notification here. You can click on download and all these highlighters will be available with your notes, whatever that you have added, in a PDF format. So you can use this for your reference. So this is how Pearson eText from my lab will help the students and the faculty members in creating their own notes while reading and then sharing it with the other students or other colleagues of the student. Thank you.